So I have something really exciting to share, and it's the title of this video. I have moved into a Honda Civic. So in case you don't regularly tune in to the Hobo Alley YouTube channel, my name is Alexandria and I have lived in vehicles for almost 6 years. First a Mitsubishi Lancer, then a Jeep Liberty, and then a Dodge 3500 van. And now, this beautiful tiny thing. All right, so let's cover some basics here. I do still have my van and I'll be back in there at some point. The Honda home is only temporary, but it is definitely gonna last for a good while. And I didn't go out and just buy a second vehicle. This one comes with an owner, which has definitely added to the dynamic of this little adventure. And I have a feeling that the number one question I'm gonna get is, why move into a Honda Civic? Why would anyone live in a Honda Civic? Especially given the fact that I have a giant van. Well, I'm gonna answer that in a second, but first I'm gonna get out of here because one, it is hot. And two, it is beautiful outside. So let's go out there. So why? Why am I doing this? There's kind of like two parts to this. The first would be the spiritual side of things. And y'all, let me tell you, I prayed long and hard about this. And basically the consensus that I got was like, yeah, you need to do this. So there's that one. And secondly, there's the more logistical side of things. And that would be the fact that like there was a very specific route that I'm currently on that I needed to take in a very, very specific time frame. And it covers a lot of distance in a very short amount of time. And the Honda happens to get about triple the gas mileage of the van, making this way more cost effective. Because honestly, the route that I'm on, there's no way, like ever, that I would travel it in the van at this pace. It would just be way too fast, way too pricey. And we're gonna go back in the car because I didn't realize that it's kind of windy. And also I keep scouting for bears and turkeys and all kinds of things. I'm getting a little sketched out. So we're just gonna go be where it's a little bit safer.
Oh, okay, back in the car. And not that I'm afraid of turkeys or anything. I just like might be afraid of turkeys. It's more of like wild animals, you know? Like I just don't trust them. They're wild. They can do whatever they want. They will do whatever they want. So this is just a much easier place to relax and talk to you and not constantly be like on my guard, like, is there a bear? Is there a turkey? Is there a bear? Is there a turkey? So here we are. Now, of course, there's gonna be pros and cons with any vehicle, but for me, this is really exciting. I think it's good to switch things up every once in a while and do something outside of my comfort zone, because that's really where I feel like I grow the most, is when I put myself out there and I don't know what's gonna happen, or I don't know how it's gonna be, or it potentially seems like it's like completely gonna go completely wrong or bad. It's just kind of like anytime that I can change things or do something that I'm like, I don't know if I can do that. Like, to me, that's exciting because that means growth, that means lessons, that means life. And so, yes, even though it is a small, small space, I am just so stoked to be able to have this opportunity to try living in a car this size. So I'm kind of looking at this as just kind of like an experiment, a cool challenge, a new adventure. Because as I said earlier, I've lived in a four-door sedan before, but that was at the beginning of the 6 years of living in cars. That was my first car living experiment. And I'm not gonna lie, it was kind of a hot mess. So it has been really interesting to downsize again, but this time knowing all of the things that I know, and I don't know everything, I just know more about how to live like this functionally. And the types of stuff that I'm referencing would be like how to stay organized, how to stay safe, my travel style, easy meals to cook on the road, where to park to sleep, where to get water, how long I can comfortably sustain myself off grid, all of those types of things. And so now, knowing the things that I do know, it's been fun like coming back into this tiny of a space and trying to apply all of the things that I've learned the past like 5.5 to 6 years and see if I can make this livable or if it's still just a hot mess because it's too small. And then on top of that, you add the dynamic of a whole nother person because I've never lived in any size vehicle with another person before. And then if you want to take it another level deeper than that, they've never lived in a car before ever. So this is their first car living experience to just icing on the cake, cherry on top. There you go with all of that. So it has been so fun and so interesting, and I cannot wait to catch y'all up on all that has been happening since moving into the Honda Civic to where I am now and continuing forward. So right now, let me just kind of get out and show you what we're working with back there. I'm not going to give you like a full tour because how much of a tour can you really get in a Honda Civic? It's a Honda Civic. There you go. There's the tour. But no, I'm going to show you just a little bit of what we're working with in the back there. A lot of our stuff is out of the car right now. But again, I'm just going to show you real quick so you can get an idea
All right, here we go. How does that look? Claustrophobic much? So there's definitely some stuff happening, but it's kind of hard to even show you what's going down. Here's like from the passenger chair. Again, can't really see anything. That's why the tour thing or our setup / organization is gonna have to wait for a little bit until I can get these out of here. But there's definitely a bed back here in some kind of a way.
And I promise there is a method to all that madness. We have a place for everything. We know where everything goes, stuff like that. So the next couple of videos will be just that. It will be catching y'all up on the bed build, how we did that, what it looks like with all this stuff out of here so you can actually see it and how it functions, and just kind of us preparing for the Honda Adventure. So after that, y'all will be hanging out with us a little bit more in the present, and you'll be able to see how everything has been holding up. I hope that you enjoyed this little update from the future, and I will see you guys next time.